Most people in America are familiar with safety laws and what we are and are not able to do to another human being without their permission. What's absolutely fascinating in Champaign, Illinois, is that doesn't seem to matter one thing to a variety of groups of people. In my time here in Champaign, Illinois, where I had originally started off to do some sort of different work than I am doing now, I have found that people are quite abusive and intrusive in my life. Abusive in that they have cut off more than 4 inches of my priest beard that I grew for my religion, which is an invasion of my faith. Additionally, they have sexually assaulted me by doing other things to my body without my consent through the ill will that is brought about by CBD oils and other types of audio technology that can shut a person down. I began reporting about this some time ago with my journalism degree and my reporter's notebook some time ago. If I repeated myself, please forgive me because I have had a stroke and sometimes my mouth doesn't always catch up with my brain, and that's sort of difficult for me. What I can tell you about my day today is that I spent the day mainly preparing for scripts and other things I'm working on in a writer's way. You see, when you're a writer, you have opportunities to do all sorts of content creation and script writing and other types of videos for commercials and promoting of people. And I usually talk about my work from my Making Moments Matter project days of protecting people or promoting people, politics, programs, and products. In that realm, there's a lot of writing opportunities for an individual like me to utilize a variety of skill sets. But what I can tell you today about my afternoon, my late afternoon, is that I left the space that I typically work in quietly today because of a very boisterous, noisy, young black dance troupe that kind of took over the sidewalk. For the most part, it was a positive experience to observe. However, from a pagan perspective, and from an advertising perspective, and from a promotional perspective, I have a lot of different comments on it. And from a writer's and reporter's perspective, I have other ideas. To begin with, the group was poorly marketed in that they had only handwritten posters. Not that that's bad, because the kids were basically roughly as young as babies, although obviously that one was a dancing, but from the age of about 5 up to maybe 16 or 17. The women who were leadership in the group were rather boisterous and quite obnoxiously loud in comparison to what I'm accustomed to being around. But that's just a humble old man's opinion that I do feel like that some of their use of music and shouting was sort of in a violation of local city and what should be noise ordinances. I also kind of marveled that when I did ask about their food, they were somewhat discriminating in the beginning of their mood, meaning I'm a white old man and they're a group of black women. And openly, I did not want to be intrusive, but if you're expecting me to provide you some cash towards some baked goods, I'm of course curious who made the baked goods, what kind of a professional kitchen were they made in, and are there any type of laws in this state that protects us from homemade goods? Now, I realize that we have all kinds of kids who do this all over America and have been doing it for years, but in a time of COVID, we also have the right to know who's been handling the food. The other thing I observed from a marketing perspective was an incredible inability for them to qualify their customers. They often send out girls who are 6 to 8 to interact with some of the public, and the problem with that is that the kids were carrying around the desserts that they had made to give to people for donations, but I never really saw that. What I saw was young girls collecting donations but not handing over the goodies in their hand or not inviting them to the table for a second look. And of course there are some people like, I don't want your food because it is the time of COVID. And because you're a little girl, I can't know that you did anything good. But they also, being a hot day, they might not like the sugars that could be melting and frosting and whatnot for their own health. But again, it's just an observation of a marketing man. I also made some notes about on their website, which was just a Facebook page, that when I went to try to look, I was kind of told that it was not some sort of safe page. Now, Facebook keeps changing, just like a lot of technology companies keep changing their interface. So I can't say that I'm expert at all in that, because most of the people that I interact with do not actually produce their business from Facebook. There are certainly marvelous gurus, leaders, national speakers, famous people like Vice President Harris, President Joe Biden, or Oprah, people like that who have marvelous training and following on a Facebook channel, but I don't feel that it is right for what I do mainly for a living. But that's just my opinion on it. But as a marketer looking at the Facebook page, I felt some things were missing, and openly my notes are pretty straightforward about what was missing for this troupe. What I felt was that they needed a YouTube channel if they were going to show off their dance routines. I also felt that their logo possibly was causing the misrepresentation, and they need to do some re-representation or representation of that. they had kind of infringements notes on the Facebook page, as I said, when I landed. And that sort of barred people like me from actually liking the page. And they also needed to do something a little bit better with their logo. It seemed like they had multiple different logos, and that's not always great because it might show the history of a group, but it can be confusing for people. Clearly, when I went to look up the About page, they had no mission statement, no value statement, no non-for-profit standing information, and they did not show any of the awards that they had claimed. They'd gone to a lot of dance competitions. Based on what I saw in their little demonstrations, they had a constant stream of changing hot music, pop music, rap music, and then slow, more ballad, blues music, and it was a completely rapid movement situation, so I wasn't really in the mood to hear that. If it was played at a slightly lesser decibel, I might have been better at producing some feedback, but truthfully, it was sort of an obnoxious scene. I also felt that children were sort of put in the lurch a little bit, and they hadn't really prepared themselves in how to train the girls on how to sell what they were working on. Now, apparently they landed a bit shy of their goal today, and I'm sad for that because they probably could have done better, but again, people don't like to be barraged by people, and there was quite a lot of them, and I did notice the expressions and reactions of people coming in and out of the store, which wasn't as completely positive, and I think it was just not the number of them that were there, but it was just the overwhelmingness of children running here and there.